We are going to study about the French Revolution. The French Revolution, the first chapter of Nine Glass. And in this chapter, we are going to study about the French Revolution. It's already, you can understand the French. It is our country in Europe, France. And they are talking about our language, that is French. That is why this name is given, the French Revolution. Revolution means a rooted change. One society, otherwise one country or some group of people were changed routine. That is called a revolution. That is why the French Revolution. The French Revolution. It was happened in the France 1789. The first year, seeds of the revolution started in the France. And we are going to study about in this lesson about the French revolutions and what is the reason for the revolution and what is the consequence of the revolution. We are going to study about what is the reason of the French Revolution and what is the result of the French Revolution and how it is happened in the France, and these matters we are discussing in this chapter. And the French Revolution, already I said that it started in 1789 July 14th. The first seed of the revolution started in the France in 1789 July 14th. And then the revolution, why this revolution happened in the France? So already we know that the France is a one industrial revolution country or industrial country in the Europe. And they were, the industrial countries were competing each other in the 17th and 18th century. At that time, the France and the Britain were against it. They were occupied a lot of colony in America, Africa, Asia and some other part of the world. And that time, the 1789, the France government or the France king was helped American colonies to become independent from Britain, and many American colonies were under controlled by Britain. That time the France was helped the American colonies to become independent from the British. And this was many years of the war. Many years of the war and many economical development and economical problems happened in the France. And when 1789, July 14th, it was the first seed of the French Revolution. Started, and we are going to study about the history behind it, when it is happening. And I am going to say about the French revolutions. Firstly, I would like to say the reason. One of the reasons I already said that the Britain and France were the one industrial developed country in the Europe in the 17th century as well as in the 18th century. At that time, the France helped American colonies to become independent from the Britain, and that war was continued many years. Not only 1 year, many years. Many of the economical reforms happened in that time. Many of the money of the French government spent a lot of money for this war. And at that time, up to 1789, the French treasury was empty. At that time, the 20-year-old Louis XVI came to the throne of France. And Louis XVI came to the throne of the France, and he married an Australian princess, Marie Antoinette. And Louis XVI, when he came to the throne, he was 20 years older. He married an Australian princess, Marie Antoinette. And when he came to the throne, the French treasury was empty. No money remains in the treasury. That was the situation. Louis XVI came to the power. And then, immediately he made some economical reforms in the country, and the people were suffering from this increasing taxes day by day because of the extravagance of the palace and the nobles and many other the Versailles palace were full of extravagance and full of corruptions. These situations, Louis XVI came to the power. He was forced to increase the tax. There was no way in front of the Louis XVI. Immediately he called his ministers and he increased the tax, and it was many times increased, and again the Louis XVI came, that time also increased it. It was affecting the France. There were the 90% of the French people were peasants, and 10% only nobles and clergy. Clergy means the priests of the church, or they were the Christian countries, they were the clergies, were the fathers and the bishops, and like that the high families were considered as clergies, and the nobles, they were the aristocrat family, they were the roving family members, they have a special privilege. They don't want to pay any tax in that country. They were free from the tax, but in the 90% of the peasants means they were, we can say another word, farmers. What is the difference between the peasant and farmers? The peasant means they were working, they have no bit of land, they were working others' land and earning daily bread. They were called the peasants. The farmers means those who have a piece of land, they were cultivating and producing from the field, they are called the farmers. That is the difference between peasants and farmers. And the 90% of the France populations were peasants, and 10% were clergy and nobles. They were free from the tax, and all the tax they wanted to pay by the peasants. It was the situation, and they have no piece of land. They have no piece of land. They were working others' land and earning their money. That money is also, they have to pay the church, they have to pay the clergy, and they have to pay to the tax. The day by day, it was increasing. That was the situation of the France when the Louis XVI came to the power in France. Do you understand what is the difference between peasants and farmers? So peasants, those who are working in the other's land and earning their livelihood, they were called peasants. And farmers, they have on land, they are cultivating on the land and producing from their field. They were called farmers. That is the main difference between peasants and farmers. And already I told 90% of the France or French peoples were peasants. And 10% nobles and clergy. They were free from the tax. That was the situation of the France. And then Louis XVI came to the power. And already I said that the 1789, July 14th, the first seeds of the revolution started. It was scattered. The small city of France, Versailles, the small city of Versailles, the many peoples were gathered in front of the town hall. About 7,000 of the peoples, including men and women, were gathered in front of the town hall of the Versailles city. And the king informed the troops, to control the people. And they were gathered, 70,000 of the people of the France were gathered in front of the small town in Paris. 70,000 of the men and women were gathered in front of the town hall in the Paris, and the king ordered the troops to move forward to the people. The people were gathered there. They were gathered to take action against the government. And the troops already moved forward. The people were gathered and they were made a militant. People militant. And they wanted ammunition. That means gun and bullet, like that thing. That is why immediately they were attacked in Versailles prison. The 70,000 of people, the including men and women, marched to the Versailles jail. It was in Paris. It was attacked by this mob. And all the prisoners were freed. And all the jail or the fortress jail were demolished, and the fortress were demolished, and the people gathered the stones of the Versailles prisons, the stones of the remains of the Versailles prison stones, and they have taken to their home and kept it as a souvenir of the starting of the French Revolution. It was happened in the 1789, July 14th. And one more thing also I would like to say about what is the consequence of these revolutions. So already we hear the liberty, equality, freedom. Liberty, equality, freedom. The first thing we heard these words from the French Revolution. The first word, liberty, swatantrata, equality, samanata, and freedom. Ajani. And that word was spread all over the world. Liberty, equality, freedom. And One of the another consequence of the French Revolution, it was the end of the monarchy system in France. Because the French was under control of the kings. They were ruled their country. It is called, they were called the monarchies. The French Revolution, one of the consequences of the French, or one of the results of the French Revolution, is the end of the monarchy system in the France. Afterwards, many other countries followed this method, these ideas. What is this idea? Liberty, equality, and freedom. And what another consequence? It was end of the monarchy system in France, and many of the countries followed that. And next one, the first time the world heard about the right of a man. It was heard in the French Revolution, the right of the man and equality of the man. It was, and then the revolutionists offered the people a good era in front of you, and we will show a good time in front of you. And like that, many other imaginations or dreams, the people of France participated in this French Revolution. It changed the world, and it was changed the thinking of the people, and it was following India as well as China and many other countries. And these ideas already borrowed from French Revolution. And again, tomorrow we will study about the revolution very clearly, about the lessons. I will explain from one paragraph by paragraph tomorrow. You will wait for me. Thank you.